Hello everyone, welcome back. Continuing what we studied in the previous lecture, this is the topic which we are going through. We had done physical quantity in the previous lesson. Physical quantity, as I can just going through a short revision, anything that has a unit and a magnitude is a physical quantity. Physical quantities in your syllabus are, you can say, five important physical quantities are length, mass, time, temperature, electric current. These are base physical quantities. You cannot study any physical quantity that does not have these as part of them, and this is actually the part of today's syllabus. Luminous intensity and amount of substance, these are two physical quantities that will just be named in your syllabus. You will not study them in any calculation or any topic. These are the quantities which is actually part of physics but not at your standard. So conversions, these are prefixes. Prefixes are most important when you are solving questions, and the data which is given in the question is not in the SI unit. You will be needing these prefixes so that you can convert that data into the SI units. This was part of the previous lecture. Now what we are going to do today is homogeneous equations. Homogeneous equations are those equations that have the same units on both sides of the equation. As you can see in this example, I have written an equation which is V is equal to U plus AT. This is actually the same equation which is equation of acceleration. A is equal to V minus U upon T. If you make V the final velocity subject, it will become V is equal to U plus AT. Now in this equation, V is equal to U plus AT, I have written the SI base unit of V, which is velocity, ms minus 1. Similarly, U is initial velocity, its unit is ms minus 1 as well, meters per second. Acceleration is ms minus 2 meters per second square. Time is in seconds, so it's multiplied by s. If you simplify this, you will see that on the left hand side it's ms minus 1, on the right hand side it's ms minus 1 plus ms minus 1, because ms minus 2 times s becomes ms minus 1. Ms minus 1 when added to ms minus 1 becomes 2 ms minus 1. So ms minus 1 is equal to 2 ms minus 1. As you can see in this equation, the unit on the left hand side and the unit on the right hand side both are equal. This is a constant. Constant does not change the homogeneity of equation. So any equation that is homogeneous will have same units on either sides of the equation. All the equations which we study in physics are homogeneous in nature. If they are not homogeneous, they will not be valid. Now moving on to the next topic, you have to make three columns. One is for quantity, other one is for SI units, and the third column is for SI base units. Now in the first column I have written force, and the SI unit of force is Newton. In the third column, you cannot write any unit other than SI base units. You have five SI base units in your syllabus. I have already told you: meter, kilogram, second, Kelvin, and ampere. Now in order to find out the unit of SI base unit of Newton, you will use the equation F is equal to ma. Now you know that Newton is the SI unit, but you do not know what is its SI base unit, so you will use the equation which is F is equal to ma. F is actually force. Force is measured in newtons. Mass has SI unit kg, and acceleration has SI unit ms minus 2. So kg ms minus 2 is the SI base unit of force, and the SI unit of force is Newton. Similarly, if we solve it for work, the SI unit of work is joule, and in order to find out the SI base unit of joule, you will be going through its equation. Work done is equal to force multiplied by distance traveled in the direction of force. So work is measured in joules in SI unit. Force is actually kg ms minus 2 in SI base units. So I'm writing kg ms minus 2 instead of Newton here, because I'm talking about SI base units. Distance is measured in meters, so kg m square s minus 2 is the SI base unit for work. So I'll write it kgms minus kgm square s minus 2 is the SI base unit for joule. kinetic energy or gravitational potential energy, both are actually the same physical quantities as work done. So SI unit for work is joule, so SI unit for kinetic energy is also joule. Now in order to find out SI base units of kinetic energy, I'm using the equation kinetic energy is equal to 1 upon 2 mv square. In this equation, 1 upon 2 is constant, so you will ignore this. Kinetic energy is joule, mass is in kg, speed is ms minus 1, but it is squared, so it will become m square s minus 2. And as you can see, the SI base unit for work is also kg m square s minus 2. So you have the same SI base unit for kinetic energy as well, because the dimensions are same. Now if we talk about power, the SI unit for power is watts, but in order to find out SI base unit for power, you will use its equation. Power is work done per unit time, and you can also write it as joule per second. Instead of joule, I can write kg m square s minus 2 divided by second, so it will become kg m square s minus 3, right? Similarly, the other base physical quantity is potential difference. You also call it voltage. Voltage is the SI unit, or you can say, you can call voltage potential difference, EMF, both when you are talking about them. So volt is the SI unit for potential difference, and in order to find out the SI base unit of volt, you have to go through its equation. The equation for power is V into I, right? So if I make V subject, so it will become V is equal to P upon I. It means the SI base unit of power divided by SI base unit of current will give you SI base unit of voltage, right? So SI base unit of power is kg m square s minus 3, and SI base unit of current is ampere, so it will become kg m square s minus 3 A minus 1. So let's write it here, kg m square s minus 3 A minus 1. Now resistance, SI unit of resistance is ohms, and in order to find out the SI base unit, you will use equation in which there is resistance and the other variables that have unknown unit. So R is equal to V upon I, and in order to find out the SI base unit of R, you will make R subject, so it will become V upon I, right? So V is kg m square s minus 3 A minus 1. If V is divided by I, which is ampere, so it will become kg m square s minus 3 A minus 2. Similarly, charge is coulombs. If you use Q is equal to IT, let me write this equation for you. If you write Q is equal to IT, this is actually the equation we get from the formula of current, I is equal to Q upon T, right? So Q is equal to IT, where I is current, so you will write A for current, ampere, and time for, time is in seconds, so it will become AS. Similarly, pressure is, the SI unit for pressure is pascals, and SI base unit will be obtained by P is equal to F upon A. Pressure is equal to force upon area. Force is in kg m square s minus 2, while area, sorry, force is in kg ms minus 2, while area is m square. So after cancellation, it will become kg m minus 1 s minus 2. So this was all for the second lecture of the first topic, which is physical quantities and units. In the next lesson, we will be discussing about vectors and its addition, its resolution, and everything related to the syllabus for vectors. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.